with the today's session. Now, yesterday, in the last session, what we have studied regarding the touching circles. Now, the circles, they touch each other externally or internally. So, when they touch externally, the distance between the radius is what? It is the addition of the radii of both the circles. Now, for example, if say this is circle 1, this is circle 1 with center P, and this is circle with center Q. They are touching each other at point Q. So what happens is, see, they are touching each other at point R. It is at point R. So what happens is, the distance between the radii is going to be addition of PR plus RQ, the two radius. Is this clear? Now check. We had finished till question number 3 yesterday. We are moving to question number 4. Now in question number 4, what they have given is, they have given two circles with center P and Q. They are given two centers with center P and Q, touching each other at point R. And you have to get these things done to prove that segment AP is parallel to segment BQ. Then you have got to prove triangle APR similar to triangle RQB, and you have to find angle RQB if angle PAR equals to 35 degrees. Is this clear to all? Yes, those are raising their hand. What is your problem, beta? Now let's move ahead. So what happens is, check. To prove AP parallel to BQ, what you need is, you need to get the triangles similar so that you get some angles congruent, and with help of that, either you can apply the corresponding angle property or you can apply the alternate angle property or the interior angle property to show the lines parallel. Now we have to move ahead thinking on all this methods to solve. Now when you look at the figure, now check, the radii of both the circles are going to be different. But what happens here is, these two triangles, they are isosceles triangles. Now, why they are isosceles triangles? Because check, AP is equals to PR, radii of the same circle. So, these base angles, I'm writing here X and X. So, these base angles are going to be equal. Similarly, when you move to the other triangle, triangle RQB, you're going to get the same things here. RQ is equals to QB. This is again the radii of the same circle. So if the radii of the same circle, again you're going to get the base angles equal by isosceles triangle property. So you have got these base angles equal. Now you try to establish a relation between X and Y. You try to establish relation between X and Y. Now, how can you relate that? How can you relate between X and Y? X and Y are going to be congruent by, check, X shape vertically opposite angles. Understood? So, these two angles are congruent. So what you can state is that by angle test, the two triangles, they are similar. And once they are similar, you can get the lines parallel, or once you get this lines parallel to each other, check these two angles congruent to each other, you can get AP parallel to QB. That also you can do it. Yes, those who are raising their hands can ask the doubt. Now, in triangle APR, in triangle APR, AP equals to PR, radii of the same circle. They are radii of the same circle. Yes, Anchal, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar School. You can ask beta, what is your problem? APR is an isosceles triangle. Yes, beta.
Sir, mujhe symmetry AP double or SPPQ mein kya hota hai?
Kaun sa beta?
Second wala jo aapne likha hua hai upar.
Ye wala?
नहीं ये
ये
ये नहीं इसके ये
ये ट्रायंगल APR सिमिलर टू ट्रायंगल RQB.
यस,
वो आपको प्रूव करना है, वो आपको प्रूव करना है कि ये दो ट्रायंगल्स कैसे सिमिलर हैं. ओके, सो ट्रायंगल APR इज एन आइसोसेलिस ट्रायंगल. सिमिलरली ट्रायंगल RQB is an isosceles triangle. We see what you are going to get. Triangle RQB is an isosceles triangle. क्योंकि RQB में भी क्या होता है? You are going to get RQ congruent to QB. You are going to get RQ congruent to QB. So this is what the isosceles triangle property. If two sides are equal, the base angles are also going to be equal. So with help of that, what you are going to get, therefore, check angle PAR is congruent to angle PRA and angle QRB is going to be equal to angle QBR. This is by isosceles triangle theorem. Yes. Yes, Gaurav beta, what is your problem beta? You can ask. Yes, beta, what is your problem? You can ask, Gaurav. So till here, everyone is clear that how did we get these two base angles equal? After getting those base angles equal, we move ahead. What happens is we have to prove the relation between X and Y. This relation between the two angles of the two different triangles, how they are congruent. Now, angle PRA is equal to angle QRB. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. So you have got the relation between these two. So once you get relation between these two, what happens is, check, this angle PAR is going to be equal to angle QBR. So check, two angles equal. So that means the third angle which is there, that third angle is also going to be equal. Now, for example, if you give this as statement number one, statement number two, This is statement number 3. So what you are going to get in triangle PAR and triangle QRB. Okay, so from 1, 2, and 3. Okay, if you combine this 1, 2, and 3, you are going to get angle APR is congruent to angle BQR. Yes, Anchal, you can ask Vidya. So till here, everybody have understood how did we get this third pair of angle congruent? As two pairs of angles are already congruent, we are going to get the third pair of angle congruent. Is this clear to all? Now let's move ahead. Now once you get this, we'll move ahead. We'll get segment AP is parallel to segment BQ. Segment AP is parallel to segment BQ. How did you get this? You've got this because of the alternate angles test or alternate angles property. Is this clear to you all? So the first part of the question is done. Segment AP parallel to segment BQ. This is the first part of the question. Now let's move ahead to the second part. Now in the second part already, you've got the things which are necessary to prove the triangles similar. So in triangle APR, and triangle RQB, what you're going to get? Check angle PAR is equal to angle QRB and angle APR is equals to angle RQB . So you've got the two pairs of angle congruent. So for similarity, you require the two pairs of angle congruent. So therefore, triangle APR is similar by triangle is similar to triangle QRB by angle-angle test. You're going to get the two triangles similar. Is this understood by all? Now let's move ahead to the third part of the question. In the third part, you have to find RQB. You have to find this angle RQB. If PAR is 35, so that means value of X is equals to 35. Now check what you're going to do is, if this is 35, PAR is 35, that means QBR is also 35, as those angles are already congruent. Understood? So in this triangle, if this is 35, this angle is also 35 because both are congruent. So 35, two angles are already known in the triangle. Can you get the third angle? Yes, you can find the third angle. So what we are going to do is, we are going to find the third angle now. Check. Angle PAR is equals to angle. Which angle should I take? आर बी क्यू दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 35 डिग्रीज. इन ट्राइंगल आर क्यू बी, इन ट्राइंगल आर क्यू बी व्हाट हैपेंस इज एंगल आर बी क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू आर बी क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू बी आर क्यू that is 35 degrees. Okay, these are the base angles and we have already written that. Understood? So with help of that, now with help of that, angle RBQ plus angle BRQ plus angle RQB equals to 180 degrees. Why? The sum of the addition of three angles of the triangle is 180 degrees. The sum of the angles of triangle. Sum of the angles of triangle. Now with help of this, you have to just substitute the values. 35 plus 35 plus angle RQB equals to 180 degrees. So angle RQB is 180 minus 110. So 180 minus 110. So 180 minus 110 is how much? Sorry, I wrote 110. 180 minus 70. 180 minus 70 is how much? 180 minus 70 is 110 degrees. It is how much? 110 degrees. Is this clear to all? Students, is this clear to all, everyone? Is there any doubts regarding this? You all can remove the screenshot. You all can remove the screenshot of this. Yes, those who are raising their hands can ask me. Come on. Yes, those are having the doubts. You can unmute and ask. Remove the screenshot of this so that we can move ahead. Okay, so I'm just erasing this now. So now in question number 5, again they have given you the two circles, and what they have given is, they have given you one common tangent which is meeting the two circles, but here it is touching the circles at two different points. It's touching the circles at two different points. So that question we are going to study now. That is question number 5. Instead of writing the whole question, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to draw the figure of that question. See, in the adjoining figure, circles with center A and B touch each other at point E. So again, two circles are given. Which? Okay, so these are the two circles. Yes, Alok Beta, you can ask. They're touching each other at point E. There is a tangent. Okay. They're touching the two circles. Yes, Beta.
Sir, video clear nahi aa rahi hai.
Okay. So what is the problem, Beta? Can you tell me what is the problem? The screen is not visible.
Screen is visible, but it is not a clear.
मतलब क्या आ रहा है, वो ब्लर आ रहा है क्या?
नहीं मतलब हल्का हल्का वैसा दिख रहा है, आधा दिख रहा है आधा दिख ही नहीं रहा है.
ओके जस्ट वेट
ये देखिए, डी वाला सर्कल दिख रहा है, डी वाले रे पे जो सर्कल है, और सी वाला सर्कल बिल्कुल नहीं दिख रहा है.
ओके वेट, अभी दिख रहा है बेटा?
हाँ
ओके ओके ओके. Circles with center A and B touch each other at point E. They touch each other at point E. There is a tangent, a common tangent, which touches both the circles at point C and D, which touches both the circles at point C and D. Now what happens is, find length of CD if the radii of the circles are 4 centimeters and 6 centimeters. So what you have to do is, you just join this. This is 6 centimeters and this is 4 centimeters. So this is 4 centimeters, this is 6 centimeters. What you have to do is, you have to find the length of CD. To find length of CD. You have to find length of CD. Now this is your question. I'm going to look at the figure. Tangent is given, radius is given. So the property which we studied regarding the tangent and the radius, they are what? Perpendicular to each other. So here you're going to get angle ACD and angle BDC, both 90 degrees. So that also I'm marking it in the figure. Is this clear? So that we are going to write it afterwards. Now what happens is, you have to draw. Here you need to do a small construction, because you cannot prove this question directly. You cannot find length of CD directly. So what you're going to do is, you're going to do a small construction. Centimeters, this is 6 centimeters. You're going to do a small construction. What you're going to do is, you're going to draw AF perpendicular to BD. You're going to draw AF, which is going to be perpendicular to what? To BD. So you just draw that. So what happens here is, you're going to get CA. So for this point, what we have named? We have named this as point F. So AF perpendicular to BD. So what you're going to get? You're going to get in quadrilateral CAFD. Three angles are 90 degrees. Your three angles are 90 degrees. So that means the fourth angle which is remaining, the fourth angle is also going to be what? 90 degree. So if all the angles of the quadrilateral is 90 degrees, the given quadrilateral forms rectangle. That we have to prove first. So let's begin with our solution. Now we'll write, check angle ACD is equals to angle BDC equals to 90 degrees. Understood? This is because of what? The tangent theorem. That angle ACD is equals to angle BDC equals to 90 degrees. This is why? By tangent theorem. Radius and tangent perpendicular to each other. Now, in quadrilateral, ACDF, you can write it like this, ACDF or AFDC, whatever it is, either going clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So in quadrilateral ACDF, okay, angle ACD equals to angle BDC and equals to angle AFD equals to 90 degrees. Now check, this is from statement number one, this is from construction. So just what we'll do is we'll write this as statement number one. So this you are going to get from one and construction. So you have got the three angles equals to 90 degrees each. So that means the fourth angle which is remaining. Therefore, angle CAF is equals to 90 degrees. So you're going to get the remaining angle CAF as 90 degree. So after that, you've got this angle as 90 degree. What happens next is, therefore, your quadrilateral ACDF is a rectangle. By the definition of rectangle, all the angles are 90 degrees. So ACDF becomes a rectangle. So now, if this is going to become a rectangle, that means your value of AC is going to be equal to value of FD, that is equals to 4. Sorry. AC equals to FD equals to 4 centimeters. Is this clear to all? Till here. Now, if suppose DF is 4, can you find value of BF? Can you find value of BF or FB? Now check. FB or say BF is equals to BD minus DF or say FD. Understood? Because F is between B and D. That is the reason for this.
It should be D dash F dash B.
Now after that, you have to just substitute the values. Value of BD is 6 minus 4. That is equals to 2 centimeters. That is equals to how much? 2 centimeters. Now we'll just separate this triangle out. We're going to separate this triangle out. So what happens here is, angle DFA is 90 degrees. So that means angle AFB is also 90 degrees. So here I'm going to show that as 90 degrees, say F, here it is B, here it is A, here it is point E in between, this 4 and 6 which has been shown, and you have got value of this as 2 centimeters. Now when you look at the figure, what happens here is value of AB is AE plus EB. Value of AB is AE plus EB. So that means it is what? 4 plus 6. That is equals to 10. Now first we'll find value of EB. Sorry, AB. AB equals to AE plus EB. This is A dash E dash B. So that is 4 plus 6. 10 centimeters. Understood? Now check. In a right angle triangle, if two sides are given to you, can you find the third side? You can find the third side with help of Pythagoras theorem. Now check. In triangle AFB, angle AFB equals to 90 degrees. This is by construction, because you have drawn AF perpendicular. So you have got angle AFB equals to 90 degrees. After that, which is the hypotenuse? The side opposite to the right angle. Hypotenuse is AB. So AB square equals to FB square plus AF square. So therefore, just substitute the values. 10 square equals to 2 square plus AF square. So AF square is 100 minus 4, that is 96. Now we have got value of AF square. We need to get value of AF. Now AF is root of 96. Root of 96, when you simplify that, you're going to get that answer as 4 root 6 centimeters. It is going to be 4 root 6 centimeters. But you have to find value of CD. Now, AFDC is a rectangle. So that means AF is going to be congruent to CD, opposite sides of the rectangle. Therefore, or on the next line, AF equals to CD equals to 4 root 6 centimeters, reason opposite sides of the rectangle. Opposite sides of the rectangle. Is this clear to all? Has everybody understood this? So let's move ahead. Remove the screenshot of this. Remove the screenshot of this so that we move ahead to the next part. Your practice set 3.2 is done. This is question number 5. Yes, Akanksha. Akanksha, you can ask better. Akanksha. Yes, Akanksha, those who are raising their hands, you can ask directly because I'm going to erase all this now. Yes, those who are raising their hands, can ask. Come on, first.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, जो आपने extra draw किया है वो हमें भी exam में करना है क्या?
नहीं, वो एग्जाम में नहीं करना है. दिस इज जस्ट फॉर द एक्सप्लेनेशन. आई हैव ड्रॉन दिस.
और जो डायग्राम में किया है वो सर्कल्स में वो करना है.
कौन सा? ये जो कंस्ट्रक्शन जो दिखाया है. हाँ, वो आपको दिखाने का है. दैट यू हैव टू शो.
सिंस वी हैव टू ड्रॉ फर्स्ट देन वी हैव टू डू.
यस, यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द फिगर एंड देन यू हैव टू शो द कंस्ट्रक्शन.
ओके सर.
यस बेटा.
सर, आपकी आवाज प्रॉपर नहीं आ रही है.
मींस हाउ इट इज कमिंग बेटा? इट इज It is getting what?
Sir. Sir, आपकी वॉइस नहीं क्लियर आ रही है. ब्रेक हो रही है.
अभी आ रही क्या बेटा? क्लियर वॉइस आ रही है क्या? क्लियर?
नो सर.
आपका नेटवर्क स्ट्रांग है बेटा? जस्ट चेक आपका नेटवर्क.
सर.
हाँ बेटा.
वाला फिर से बताओ ना, ACDF का.
A C D F. Okay. वो देखो क्या होता है. What happens here is in quadrilateral A C D F. Check. One, two. देखो ये दो angles. Those angles are right angle because of tangent and radius property. Tangent and radius property. That is because of tangent theorem. Now we have done a small construction. We have drawn A F perpendicular to B. So that means this angle A F D is also the right angle. Now, if in a quadrilateral, देखो quadrilateral sum of all the angles is 360. उसमें से अगर three angles 90 degrees है, 90, 90, 90, so that becomes 270. So the fourth angle is going to be 360 minus 270, which is 90 degrees. So with help of that, you are going to get angle CAF as 90 degrees. Now, as CAF is 90 degrees. In quadrilateral, if all the angles are right angles, if in the quadrilateral all the angles are right angles, that quadrilateral is called a rectangle by definition of rectangle. Understood? So this CAFT, it becomes a rectangle. After becoming a rectangle, what happens? Opposite sides are equal. So that means if AC is 4, FD is 4. If AF, now we have got that as 4 root 6. So CD is also 4 root 6. So now to get value of AF, okay, you have to just consider this triangle, AFP, in which angle F is 90 degrees. So with help of Pythagoras theorem, because this is 2 centimeters which you are going to get, this is 4 plus 6, that is 10. Yes, beta.
Sir, nice
clear, break. Wait. The other students are also facing the same problems. Students? The other students are also facing the same problem?
No, sir.
Beta, your network issues might be there, beta. Because of that, the voice may be not clear, beta.
Sir.
Yes, beta. वो ड्रॉ किया था बाजू में, ये ट्राइंगल है, इसमें से ये दो साइड अपने को दिए है, थर्ड साइड निकालने का है, दैट इज जस्ट फॉर द एक्सप्लेनेशन.
थैंक यू.
Yes, the other students, anyone who is facing any doubt? Those who have raised their hands. Now we are going to move to the next part, that is the arc of a circle. Now what is the arc of a circle? Arc of a circle is the portion which is going to lie on the circumference of the circle. Arc may be two types, a major arc or minor arc. Understood? So we'll just go to those part. We'll go to that part. Sorry. Now apne ko secant pata hai. Secant maine pehle lecture mein bataya tha. Secant kya hai? Secant is a line which divides the circle into two parts. Okay. Arc of a circle. See, this is the circle, and this is the secant. Secant is what? A line which passes through the circle, touching the circle at two distinct points. See, this is AB. The center of the circle is C. Secant is a line which passes through the circle and which meets the circle at two distinct points. That is A and B. So line L is a secant. Now what this secant has done? This secant has divided the circle into two parts. One and two. Okay. So now, whatever the portion is going to lie on the circumference. This portion is called as the arc. Is this clear to all? Now, the secant has divided the circle into two different parts. Okay, now check when it is going to come on one side of the center. So where the center is not occupied, okay, then the circle or the arc is called as the major arc. Means if the center is on one side of the secant, say this is the center, whatever the part is remaining, on the circumference, so this part, this is called as the major arc. This is called as the major arc. And where the part of the circle, where the center is not considered. देखो ये पार्ट में सेंटर आ रहा है क्या? Whether the center has been taken into consideration? No. So the part where the center is not considered, that is called as the minor arc. Understood? So the chota wala part, the smallest part on the circumference is the minor arc. The largest part is what the major arc. Okay? Now what happens is, for writing the name of this, okay, you're going to take the end points. You're going to take the end points and the point which lies in between. For example, the name of this arc, it is going to be arc AXB. You can write that as arc AB also. And arc AYB. And arc AYB. Yes, those are raising their hands. Students, you can unmute and ask. This is the arc of the circle. The next part is the central angle. Next part is the central angle. Now see, from central, you come to know that it is relating to the center. So the angle formed at the center, is called the central angle. It's called the central angle. For example, now check. If I join A with C and if I join B with C, there is an angle which is formed in the center. That angle is called as the central angle. The value of this arc, the major of the arc, corresponds to the central angle. The measure of this arc is going to be equal to the central angle. Is this clear to all? Next is the congruent arcs. Is the same as the congruent angles. Now, when are the angles congruent? When their major is equal. So, when the major of the two arcs are equal, we say that they are congruent arcs. Now, the property of sum of majors of arc. Now, this what happens here is, major of all the arcs on the circle is 360 degrees because the angle in the center is 360. Is this clear? Hope you have understood this. All the terms related to the arc of the circle, because the next practice set is going to be on arc of the circle. I'm going to erase all this. Next part is the theorem. There's one theorem which we have to do. That theorem, we are going to learn it now. The theorem states that the chords corresponding to the congruent arcs are congruent. Theorem. The chords corresponding to the congruent arcs are congruent. So the chords corresponding to the congruent arcs are congruent. So what we are going to do is, we are going to draw a circle. This is the center of the circle, B. So we have drawn one chord, AC. There is point P between AC, the arc AC. Now you are joining this. Now you are going to draw another arc. It's going to be equal to this arc AC. That arc we are going to consider that as DE. We are going to name the point in between as Q. From what the figure is in this shape. You take it at any other side also. Now for example, we have drawn it in this form. Now check. In theorem, first we write what is given to us. What we write is given to us. We are given that in circle with center B, check circle with center B, arc APC is congruent to arc DQE. This is given to us. We have to prove that chord AC, I'm going to write chord AC is congruent to chord DE. Chord AC is congruent to chord DE. That you have to show. I will begin with the proof. In triangle ABC and triangle DBE, I have written E, that should be B. So, in triangle ABC and triangle DBE, you are going to get side AB is congruent to side DB. Then side BC is congruent to side BE. Reason for both is the radii of the same circle. Now, angle ABC is congruent to angle DBE. Now, why angle ABC is congruent to angle DBE? Yes, those are raising their hands. You can unmute and ask. You can unmute and ask. This is because of the measures of the congruent arcs. Check. Congruent arcs. Arc AC is congruent to DE. So the angles which are formed at the center is also going to be what? It's going to be congruent. So with help of that, you're going to get angle ABC is congruent to angle DBE. Is this clear to all? So with help of that, you're going to get triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DBE. Sorry. DBE by side angle side test. Therefore, chord AB is congruent to chord DE. Is this clear to all? You have to just show the two triangles are congruent. Once you get the two triangles congruent, you'll get the corresponding chords also congruent. Come on, remove the screenshot of this. Remove the screenshot of this. Now, for your homework, I want you all to solve practice set 3.3, question number 1, homework. Practice set 3.3, question number 1. Is this clear to all? You can remove the screenshot of this. We are going to stop our lecture here today. Any difficulty, let me know. Those who have raised their hands, Who have raised their hands? 5 of them have raised their hands. You can ask. Yes, those have raised their hands. Abdul Rahman Sheikh, Ruchika Qate, AD, Lakshmi.
Sir?
Others, yes, Gaurav Guzar. Yes, but ask.
Sir?
Yeah. Haan.
Sir, meditation chapter 9, next one.
Kaun sa?
Menstruation.
Wo hai na, beta, chapter is there. That chapter menstruation is there. It has not been omitted. उसमें का कोई पार्ट ओमिट हो गया है. हाँ
ना,
नहीं नहीं नहीं, रिड्यूस नहीं हुआ है. इट इज देयर इन योर सिलेबस मेंस्ट्रुएशन. सी ओनली 25% ऑफ द सिलेबस इज रिड्यूस्ड. वो बीच में एक सर्कुलर आया था. ओके, सो दैट सर्कुलर वाज फेक. उसमें उन्होंने मेंसुरेशन कट किया था, उन्होंने स्टैटिस्टिक्स कट किया था. ओके, सो डोंट गो विद दैट सर्कुलर. जो पहला वाला सर्कुलर विच केम इन मंथ ऑफ जून, आई थिंक जून जुलाई. ओके, सो दैट सर्कुलर यू हैव टू गो विद. एंड इन दैट आई थिंक द लेटर पार्ट रिगार्डिंग द स्पीयर्स इज नॉट देयर इन योर सिलेबस. पहले 3 एक्सरसाइजेस है उसमें के, उसके बाद में वाले जो एक्सरसाइज है वो रिड्यूस हुए हैं. Okay, so that chapter is there in your syllabus. Okay?
Okay, sir.
The other students, come on.
Sir,
huh? But your voice is not clear.
Sir,
trigonometry.
Huh, 6.2.
वो भी है ना बेटा आपके सिलेबस में. 6.2 इज आल्सो देयर.
6.1 है ना, 6.2 रिड्यूस है.
इरफान बेग है ना, 271 एलसी नंबर. देखो एलसी.
नहीं 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 बेटा, वो 6.2 भी है आपको.
सिर्फ ऑनलाइन भरा था, उसमें बेग भरा था.
या एनी मोर डाउट्स?
हां
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, we can wind up, sir.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Students, thank you very much. After 10 minutes, you'll have your next lecture. Thank you, students. Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I can leave, ma'am, then?
Yes, you can leave, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.